name's Joseph Tawadros and I play the oud, the Middle Eastern lute. We immigrated when I was two. We loved Egypt and my parents loved Egypt and they always talked about it. We used to watch these movies and especially the old period. It was really a Middle Eastern Hollywood. People used to go there to find stardom from all over the Arab world. And I saw a movie on the Arabic composer Sayed Darwish, who was a very revolutionary figure and composed the Egyptian national anthem. And there's a scene where he picks up his dad's gold watch, holds it up to his ear, and an oud solo starts to play, and then he swaps the gold watch for an oud and starts his journey. And I was thinking, wow, this is cool, maybe I could do that. But dad didn't have a gold watch. So I was around 10 years old, and we found a family friend who had an oud, and that's where it started for me. There's an ancient Egyptian prototype called nefer, and nefer is actually an instrument that looks very much like the oud. And then that was taken by the Persians and developed into an instrument called the barbat, which is basically like the modern day oud. And then that was taken by the Arabs and most famously taken to Spain in the 9th century by a player called Zeriab, and it spread around Europe and became the lute. And then the lute became the guitar. So there's a nice lineage there and a very, historically significant musical instrument. Is an open fingerboard, no frets, and played with this thing here, which is called a risha, and risha in Arabic means feather, and it used to be an eagle's quill. Most ouds are six course, and I've added the seventh course there, but that's because I want a wider range. When I say a course, they're grouped. So I have five double strings and two single strings. We have the peg box here, this is where the strings line, and the front of it is usually just two types of wood. It's either cedar or spruce, and then at the back, these are individual pieces of wood that are bent over a mold. Mine is made up of zebrano, a wood called veng, and paddock. And as you can see, there's mother of pearl on the front. Music is microtonal. They use quarter tones, and quarter tones are pitches within pitches. Now I play an Arabic mode with the third note being a quarter tone. You'll hear that I can fit an interval in there. So here's major, minor, quarter tone. So that's used in the Middle East, whereas in the West, quarter tones are seen as out of tune, so that's why they put metal bits on a guitar to try and cancel them out and make the player play in tune, whereas in the Middle East, they're really prized and it's very much a part of the music. Music, there's 55 chord modes, scales essentially. It's called the makam. So when you're improvising, there's something called takasim. Takasim is a form where you start on one mode and then you modulate to wherever you want. And the prowess of a player is seen by how he or she can modulate to all different places but then return to the original makam. Last album, To Those Who Came Before Us, is a 1 hour takasim. Usually takasims are 10 to 15 minutes in their longest form. So I thought, you know what, it's my 20th album, I'm gonna try and undertake this one take, 1 hour, and I did. And so I'm really happy with it. But it's also challenging myself within that and finding these rhythms and working through different scales and modulating and going through the whole wide gamut of it and then returning to the original mode at the end. Winning Aras is a great recognition. I'm pretty excited about, you know, having seven and bringing the oud to the forefront, which is good. But at the end of the day, awards don't fuel what you do. They're just a kind of a colour and a compliment to what you've been doing. Oh yeah, James, great. You know, it's great to play with family. It's easy to rehearse, for starters, when you're growing up. They're just there, just going to the bedroom. It's not just that he's my brother. He's an incredible player in his own right, and he brings a certain style to it. We like to bring that fun. People are too serious in music. Traditionalists don't like it, and it's so funny. I'm almost enjoying it now. The trolling online's getting a bit too much. We did a clip where we're playing. I was just on my back, a bit upside down, and James was standing over me. And you should see the comments. When you play the oud, you should be playing upright. This is disrespectful to the music. It's just having a bit of fun with it and presenting it in a way where we take the music seriously and not ourselves. It's a weird thing. I don't know how it was all created. Like, this is the thing that's blowing my mind. You know, I remember it kind of happened, but I don't remember that the work that I put into it. I must have put some work into it for it to be there, to exist. I'm glad that there are actually recordings, otherwise I wouldn't believe it. But it's a weird thing, you know, you kind of just keep on doing it because I do love it. It's something that's a little bit different, and hopefully I've left a stamp.